The car of the future met the engineers of the future in Rochester today. Representatives from Tesla, the company building the first totally electric car, were among 200 companies at the RIT Career Fair, looking for the best and the brightest. Ray Lovato was there as well and talked with some pretty excited students today, Ray.
Rich, charged and ready. That describes both the new electric sports car, the Tesla, and the young men and women we saw out at RIT today who would love to work for Tesla to develop the cars of the future.
This career fair is one of two big ones each year at RIT, and all the big companies were here: Google, IBM, Apple, Microsoft. But the longest line was for Tesla.
Okay, and what do you know about Tesla?
I first learned about you guys when I was in high school, and the coolest thing would be to own one of your roadsters.
Right, one day.
And even cooler would be to build them.
Timothy Francis is a third-year electrical engineering student and 2008 graduate of Webster Schrader High School.
To be able to work with a company that manufactures the only electric car on the market that goes over 200 miles on one charge, would be just a dream job for me.
Christian Moreno is earning both his bachelor's and master's degrees in November.
The electric cars, they're fantastic. They look amazing.
Tesla started in Silicon Valley in 2003 and now has 800 employees. The Roadster hit the streets in early 2008, and 1,000 Tesla vehicles are now on the road in more than 25 countries. Tesla says the Roadster costs as little as $5 to charge, equivalent to 2 cents per mile. A 20 mpg gasoline-powered car costs about 15 cents per mile. The charger's on board, so Tesla owners can simply plug into any outlet. The car is ready for a day of driving after only a few hours of charging, with a range of up to 300 miles, depending on the model. RIT is one of 15 college campuses that Tesla is recruiting from.
And really, our goal here is, how do we get our carbon footprint down? So electric vehicles are clearly one of those.
RIT's Matt Fronk knows something about alternative fuel vehicles. He started up the GM Fuel Cell Research Center in Honeyoye Falls.
You're going to have the biofuels like E85 and biodiesel. That's for more conventional type vehicles. And then the third one is really going to be around fuel cells, which are zero emissions but have also good range.
The name Tesla honors the namesake of modern electricity, Nikola Tesla, the inventor who successfully demonstrated that alternating current, the AC outlets we plug in our house, was better to illuminate America than Thomas Edison's direct or DC current, Rich.
And no Tesla vehicle on site today, huh, Ray?
Not one. We wanted to test drive one.
I bet you did. Thanks, Ray.